गुड इवनिंग ऑल. सो वेलकम क्लास 12. आई एम मिसेस श्रद्धा. आई विल बी टीचिंग यू इन्फॉर्मेटिक प्रैक्टिसेस. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, आई जस्ट वांट टू हैव अ क्विक रिव्यू ऑन व्हाट ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न इन दिस ईयर. सी, यू ऑल वर बीन अश्योर्ड इन क्लास 11 दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर ऑल द अनकम्प्लीट टॉपिक्स इन क्लास 12. सो डोंट वरी, will be going unit wise. So the units which we are going to learn in class 12 are data handling, basic software engineering, data management, and the fourth unit in the last unit is society, law and ethics. So what we are going to do now, we are going to start with the last unit, first topic, that is e-waste management. Now, what is e-waste management? E-waste management is nothing but electronic waste, which is rich source of metals such as gold, silver, copper, and which is right now of no use. For example, do you know floppy disk? Then the pen drives which are currently not in working, the computers which are not in working. Okay, so this all gets converted into a waste, but this all is a e-waste, that is electronic waste. E-waste is any electrical or electronic equipment that's been discarded. This includes working and broken items that are thrown in garbage or donated to charity reseller like Goodwill. Often if the item goes unsold in the store, it will be thrown away. But this e-waste is very, very dangerous because it emits toxic chemicals that naturally leach from metal inside them when been buried. So can you see this picture which shows you electronic waste? So much of garbage. So this e-waste is having very, very bad impact on human being, that is on human health as well as on environment. So how does it affect on your human health? See, the negative human health of these toxics on human includes brain, heart, liver, kidney and skeleton system damage. So it has always been suggested that never sleep by keeping your mobile besides your pillow. Keep it away. Always don't get ping into your mobile. This may cause vomiting, muscular pain, headache, sleeplessness, fatigue, lung cancer, abdominal pain, diarrhea, and so many effects. So you can see a chart which is showing you the effect of e-waste on environment and on human health. So pollution of ground, acidification of soil, air pollution, sound pollution, 40% of lead and 75% of heavy metal found in landfills. And human health, DNA damage, lung cancer, chronic damage, asthmatic bronchitis. You can see the picture itself make it clear that how this e-waste is having an impact on your environment. See how the landfills are being buried, have been converted to toxics. So how do we manage with this e-waste? So very simple, there are 3 R's. So these 3 R's are reduce, recycle and reuse. So what is reduce? Try to reduce the usage of electronics. Try to make optimal use so that there is no more wastage. See, people often they have fond of changing the mobile every after an 2 or 6 months. So again, the mobile, the battery, the charger, the headphone, everything gets replaced. Every now and then you get new gadgets. So you keep on changing the gadgets and the old one gets been thrown as an e-waste. So try to reduce the waste. Next is reuse. Try to give someone who is in need. Suppose now, for example, you have an Android mobile and a poor people, they are in need of the mobile, and if the mobile is in working condition, try to make reuse of that mobile by donating it to someone. And third one is recycle. Make use of products which can be recycled. Try to purchase the products which has recycling mark on it. So try to recycle the products. So if these 3 R's are been managed, then your e-waste also will get properly managed. Okay. Now we will turn towards which all are the components of e-waste management. So which components are responsible? So as we have seen, that is 3 R's, they all are there. 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse, recycle. More than that, we are going to have other components that are like collection, treatment, disposal, other critical elements of e-waste management. So try to collect them, try to treat on them, and then try to have a disposal of the e-waste. E-waste disposal methods. How do we dispose this e-waste? E-waste is disposed by collection, sorting. So try to make the groups of it, then do the processing, repair it wherever possible, recycle it, dismantling, component discovery for e-waste, and reducible disposable of e-waste. So try to sort out the e-waste so that it will get managed. Now we are going to see which all points we have been covered. So this is a very short topic. In this topic we have seen what is e-waste. Okay, then we have seen how this e-waste has an impact on our body, on human health, and on the environment, which all hazards have been caused due to this e-waste on human body as well as on environment. Then we have seen how this e-waste can be managed. So how this e-waste can get managed? This e-waste will get managed by using different methodologies like 3 R's, that is reduce, reuse, and recycle. Then we have seen the components which are essential for managing the electronic waste. So the components are like collecting the garbage, trying to sort it out, making a group which can get recycled, making a group which will not get been recycled, trying to repair the possibly items, and then trying to make use, reuse of those products. Then we have also concentrated on what is disposal methods. So how this e-waste, e-garbage will get disposed. So students, you all are requested to go through the topic, that is topic number 18, e-waste management. Read the topic thoroughly, try to understand what is e-waste. You all are dealing with this electronic waste. You all are dealing with all this electronic garbage, because nowadays we all are so much fond of new items, new things, and we all keep on constantly changing the pen drives. Floppy disk have been got replaced with pen drives. Pen drives have got been replaced with other memory card units. Then we keep on changing our desktops with the laptops, palm tops. So always we keep on calling the electronic products at our home, and then the older one gets been thrown. So you should take care that whatever older electronic gadgets which you throw out, they are not causing any hazard to human and environment. It is your own responsibility. As you take care of a garbage at your home, you try to sort it out in dry garbage and wet garbage, that is biodegradable garbage and non-biodegradable garbage. Same way, your electronic waste also should get properly managed. Try to purchase the goods which already have recycling symbol on it, so that whatever products you have been purchasing, that will get properly managed. Okay, so you all go through the notes. The topic is very easy, interesting. You all are dealing with it in your day-to-day life. If you have any doubt, you can ask on our WhatsApp group. Have a good day. Bye.